my sons, rejoicing with them, they are chanting like brooks of water. Instead of dancing, you are moving like a greater eye. So here we do this song. For the first time, to share the word of God with everyone of God present. What is the present? Those people are celebrating today. I want to sincerely thank God because for the past 1 week now, being together, they have received instructions. The professor consented to the people, give them instructions. Well, they have received instructions, but it's not sufficient until we give this instruction openly. For those they are going to leave, so that they will know that the instructions are not greater than them. Instructions come from the book, the Holy Book, which has been written through the scriptures, spiritual and spiritual. I tell my Lord Bishop, the Bishop of my own Bishop, Papa, I am grateful to you, sir, for giving me this rare opportunity to have so many talented dignitaries out of this country, but you decided to teach me to come and say what you think about the team that we have. I am grateful, sir, because of this blessing. Your interpretation is perfect for everyone of us because I have interacted with you. You have not called me because I'm your in-law. You have called me because I'm a son and son of God. I am a son of God. I am belonging to this house, and I, apart from the house where I'm from, this is a very important house to me. May God bless you. And I thank my mother in the Lord. Mama, I thank you very much. You have given me the physical food since I came. And I'm stronger when I go back. Don't forget. God will bless you for me and the entire family. My children are there. Family and the one that bears my name, Joseph. I mean, Joshua. This time I call on them now. After me. I am sincerely grateful to Papa, the coordinator, my senior teacher. It is very tremendous, very comforting, and very appreciative. Before I started any of the lectures that I did take part in on Tuesday, I said something, and I'm going to say it again. Church is more and more. We need number one. Everybody also thank you. Why is it number one? Because of his neatness. My God is beautiful. Therefore, everything here is beautiful. Your life has been beautiful, consistently, the mighty name of Jesus. When you are my child, inú mi tún mo bọ toilet mo lè ṣe tí mo ṣe fẹ́ ọ̀pọ̀ nǹkan lọ́gbọ́n sọ àyè tó bá tún bá yé tó tọ̀ tó lọ àpapọ̀ àtẹ́nu àwàkó bẹ́rẹ̀ fún àmísí sẹ́ni pàtàkì god bless you sir yàrá very good example of effective ẹ̀ṣẹ́ very taking attendance as a teacher god bless you. The presence of what? God. And the text is taken from Exodus chapter 33, verse 13 to 14. Exodus 13, 14 and 13. So 13 and 14 rather, and after 14. He says, now, therefore, I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this mission is thy gift. And he said, my presence shall go with thee, and I will give thee rest. Can somebody put your in your Bible for us? Yes, go.
The world.
The world where that started to be police, the world where they started to be satanic food, the world where they started to be all sorts of things, to the extent that they were able to have this put together to find out what God looks like. Until the man, I mean, God said, I'm going to diversify your land. Therefore, the town has been treated with a different land. That's how we are going. What we are going is that Jesus, I mean, God himself, was annihilated. He destroyed the
always of the heart. It's my prayer
that as you go ahead, especially those of you who have been sent out to the world, that they can do it. Have you read to us in the gospel? Matthew 10, that you are going to live among the world. You must have certain characteristics or certain conditions that you must take into consideration to be able to weather the situation. And as you want it, God Almighty, through the Holy Spirit, you will continue to overcome. You'll be overcome in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, we need to test it. God Almighty has the service, His service. They went in their state, in it. And that's where we are going. That's where the text has been taken. And they were facing all sorts of problems. And God told Pharaoh that he should have been adjusted to the book. So many things happen, you know. First God said, water became red, and water became blood, and so on and so forth. And at the end of the day, he released them. But as they were going, you know, what happened to them? Because they got to the rescue. This is a popular part of the Bible. And the Exodus, the book of Exodus, about the departure of Israelites to the promised land. And they were looking at the rest in front of them, left and right, were prophets, youths and gods. And they were shouting, why do you bring us from Egypt? Even though if we are slaves here, we will have a place to be buried, we will die. But here, we are supposed to be buried. We are supposed to be buried. And Moses looked up to God. He looked up to something. Who is not a human being but a super being? Who has sent him? Even though as a camera, he told him, don't worry, I'll be with you. That presence of God led the Israelites to rest. Hallelujah. And the rest is the way. When I was in Israel and they showed me that rest, it's already changing. And they went to. By the time those people were coming, the man realized that, because of the shadow, this is where I go. To that again. But God has said, I will happen to us. Of course. And he asked the forces to follow them. And God asked Moses to put it to the beginning. The rest is come. And this is what happens. All of our enemies will begin to change. I would have not prayed this prayer, but something cannot be taken away in the forward life. All the enemies who are supposed to take. Like how much was the game on the night? They were ready. In the mighty name of Jesus. But if they say God will forgive them, because God is in love with those who repent, so that they will be able to make this thing. But those who repent, they say, I think it's not fair, mother. And I'm not back to them. For the Lord has blessed me well, and I will not have it. It has been done to defend that in the mighty name of Jesus. They were going to the promised land. And that's what Exodus is all about. And they were having covenant with God at Mount Sinai. And Moses said, God, enough is enough. Your presence is more important. If you don't give me that presence, you don't go. Because I want your grace. I want something. Hallelujah. And God said, I will give you. If I was that place, God first called his people, stipulated people. And he told Moses, and look at him, where Moses later he was frustrated and used that word. That was the last straw that broke the camel. And God said, who are you? To say, my people are stipulated. Who are you? Because you can't even say, put yourself with God. Therefore, God said, you don't say to the promised land. My colleagues in the vineyard of God, always be careful whatever you use your mouth to say. Especially in the sanctuary of God, and wherever you find yourself. Everywhere you find yourself, you are a representative of God Almighty. And the word of God must always direct everything you do, so that you will not remember. God will continue to see you through in the mighty name of Jesus. God present was always being asked for by Moses throughout the time he was with them. And of course, if you read Exodus, every Exodus chapter 33, verse 18, we have quoted, and Psalm 32, verse 8, this has been justified. The presence of God guided Israelites to the promised land. And in the course of that, that presence of God gave them fellowship, irrespective of whatever. And when we are outside, we must demonstrate that. Then, of course, yes, the presence of God is a revelation of God. And that is coming out from the definition I gave in Christianity. After that, your long week, that is what I do now. After your long week, that is she said, I don't know. After that, your long week, that is my foot of water. The presence of God is the revelation of glory. The glory of God is shining. He was telling us, especially the servants of God, when they see the glory of God, you people get in each time they sing, I travel, I don't travel without my, if I don't go out of my house without my body, when they see, they say, Baba is fine. Ah, my brother. Unless God is at a very fine income, give us something now. He wants you to give us something. By that time, they are recognizing you, they are respecting you. You are not blessed. Whatever you think you can do for them, in most cases, I pray for them. Because I don't believe in speaking for you when you are. I can give you volunteers, but when you are asking, it appears as driving you. Let me tell you a short story. When my daughter was married, when she was in the last hospital, now I want to know the last year, he said that, I will be going to the final year. I want to go to this You know what she did? She went to fast. Put in my name. Baba, the people then I called the mother of pleasure and I said, oh, money. He said, let me tell you. So I tell you, the guest pastor for 3 days asking for mercy of God. And that mercy has come by receiving what he wanted to. I said, praise the Lord. That is the mercy. Those of you who want anything from the church, from your church, go on your knees, ask for mercy. God will appear to you and give you that mercy. Don't lose I'm going to show them. If you do that, it's going to be a game. But when God gives you, it's everlasting. Whatever you get from God, you want failure to do these things. To ask for the presence of God. And Moses asked for because he knew not that because he was a Samaritan. Nobody knew that because he was not having the capacity alone. The God that has called him that he must go to. He must ask and he's going to be given because he has faith in him. You must have. Don't say I am ordinary thinking. Thinking is so very important in terms of the future for me. because they are the servants of the Christian, and of course, when they are in their family, they are so close and closer to the other than this service than anybody. In fact, as far as I'm concerned, when I was in the service, I was thinking for so you must make sure that you invite that idea. Those things that bring this disappointment when you don't have the presence of God, you have frustration. Matthew 6 that frustration, Matthew chapter 6 verse 30. You have and then again, if you don't have the presence of God, you will be fearing your mood. You have the presence of God. There are so many places in the Bible where we have do not fear. Before you know what to fear, ask for the presence of God and you will give you. Because it's prayer, the power to give you. Then, worshiping like God. The moment you know how the presence of God, you get out of it. You go behind and say, it's a good one, somebody that goes, if you don't know who don't say, I want to get to go. If you don't know who don't say, you die before you get. So you must seek to God Almighty, and He's going to give you when you ask. So that then failure in all activities, then you become somebody who will not do well. It's my prayer that will not be your fortune in the mighty name of Jesus.
John 14:2,
In fact, when you read 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 8, examples of those who are not so before, which then we have what can be referred to as Jabez. We have to find this and not get the first presence of what was sitting. I don't have that to elaborate. Well, David was so was the master sinner. At the end of the day, this man, after the heart of God, because the presence of God was with him. Then we have Jacob, who said, I'm not allowed to go to you, bless me, what's your name? And he said, I am God, and Jacob, made supplanter. But he said from the day, that later, I don't want him, but this way, the blessed one. You will be blessed one in Jesus Christ. I want you to notice those who are being ordained to do. You have a lot of responsibility, but the presence of God, you always need to control to. You have to discipline yourself, you have to complete out the word of God, you have to continue to read the word of God and just as you go to just one morning. So that you have those two things, and when you read, you can analyze, and when you analyze, you practicalize, and when you practicalize, you can die. Satan cannot do so. And that's when my favorite place, my teacher was telling me when we were coming back, Papa, you always go there. So, yes, Deuteronomy 28, verses 1 to 14. Those are the things where he says, when you obey, all these good things shall be your portion. From 15 to 31, they are causing. Those causes will not be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. What of the seniors, my seniors, our seniors in Christ? Please support them. Support them. Because many things they have not done. They are starting. Even the deacons who are going to be, full streets now, they still need that support. That's one of the things we are still lacking in the profession. But thank God, in my book, my primary profession as a lawyer, we are changing with them. Neither though, but now we have a sort of development whereby the senior ones will show the way for us so that we shall be able to. We cannot love each other. Everybody from Kojo and Oyoko, you have to love God. So that also let us to act on when you do at them. Please, because you are coming down to believe them. You will not fall when you are coming down to Jesus. Because you are not obedient to them, it is those who are sick, cannot be obedient to God. It's like that. That then within your heart.
Especially in this situation, in this country, where so many things are
and don't let the problem consume us. Thank you, God, because I've had a prayer. As we go ahead in this service, that it's a beautiful one. Amen. And if you remember, many, many years ago, to come and glorify you. Thank you, because I've had a prayer. Glory be to God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Thank you.